Electromagnetism is a great use today for segregation in waste. When electric current is passed through a conductor, it becomes a temporary magnet or an electromagnet. Today I am going to narrate you a story of this man who brought a new dimension for electronics. It all started when a curious boy was born into a family of a blacksmith, as his father, being a blacksmith, earned very less. This boy was born on the outskirts of London and never had formal schooling beyond basic reading, maths and writing. He was not interested in studies and grew up as an average student. Unfortunately, his father, with the income for family, passed away at the age of 11 to 12. He searched for jobs and eventually got one with a bookbinder. Friends, today we can print books in 10 minutes, but 200 years ago, printers were a fantasy. This boy had to sew pages and make a book. Because of most of time he spent binding books, he created habit of reading. In day, he worked and night became an avid reader. A rich person gave him a ticket to a scientist lecture, impressed by his reading. Scientist lectures are awful. But at that time, scientists were the role models. They did experiments and fascinated people. The boy was overexcited for the lecture of a renowned scientist, Sir Humphry Davy. Davy was one who invented nitrous oxide, the laughing gas. This boy, unlike others, took a diary and a pen and noted every formulae, chemical names and definitions. He then made a small beautiful book and took it to Davy's lab and said, "I have brought you a gift, sir." Sir Davy was impressed, so the boy asked, would he get a job here as he loved the subject? Unfortunately, Davy had no vacancy. After a few weeks, Davy made a small accident and remembered the boy. The boy was recruited as a lab assistant. That boy was so happy. After a few days, some scientists from Cambridge with Davy were discussing a project we call today as electromagnet. This boy expressed his opinion that electrons may have some force which deflected the magnetic compass, but they drove him crazy. Boy came home and with days he experimented, he came to a project where he placed a cup with mercury, the magnet dipped in it vertically and a copper wire attached to the battery suspended around the magnet. When current flowed, the wire didn't stop to rotate around the magnet. He published this research paper and got famous and a renowned scientist. He was the father of electricity, Sir Michael Faraday, who put forth Faraday's law, electrolysis, electromagnet, and invented the transformer, the electric motor, and the generator. Today, on this occasion of 22nd September, we celebrate his birth anniversary. Sir Michael Faraday was a great and very renowned scientist. So, we call him the father of electronics because he created a new dimension for the electronics. Hope you liked the video. Do comment, like this video, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.